big hand for our special guest, the woman herself, Amelia Earhart.
Woo! Go, Amelia! Woo!
Oh, thank you for having me today.
So, Amelia, we have to know, what was your childhood like? Where did you grow up?
I was born in Ashton, Kansas, but my father was a railroad attorney, so I moved around quite a bit. I lived in so many cities like Kansas City and Des Moines, Iowa. When I was 19, I went to Ognot School, which was near Philly.
Wow, sounds like you saw a lot of the U.S. before you even learned how to fly. Which brings me to my next question. When did you first want to fly?
Well, I was at an air show in Long Beach when I got to go into a plane and ride in it with one of the pilots there. After that, I knew I wanted to fly, so I worked hard and took lessons from Netta Snook in L.A. back in 1920.
Go.
Wow, that's quite a story. When you were learning how to fly, did you have to borrow Netta's plane, or did you have your own then?
I used Netta's planes until, with the help of my mom and sister, I could buy the cannery. My first plane. It was a Canner Airster biplane. I still remember first seeing it with the bright yellow paint on it, which let me be seen from so far away.
Sounds like a plane that suit you perfectly, bright and outgoing. Did you get your pilot's license in this plane?
Yes, in fact I did. I was flying that plane when I got my license, which was actually 12 years ago today, May 15th, 1923.
Well, happy anniversary for you. That's a lot of years to have a pilot's license. You must have so many awards.
I don't know where to start. Well, okay, I've been given the Gold Medal of Honor of the National Geographic Society. That one was given to me by the president himself, Herbert Hoover. Another award I've been given was the Cross of Legion of Honor, and that came from France. And I even got the Distinguished Flying Cross from the U.S. Congress.
Those are some important awards. I bet you're proud to say that you have all of those awards. I know I would be. I am.
I hope that it helps to inspire women to never give up on their dreams and to continue fighting for equal equality among women.
Very true. I hope that women can be inspired by you and other women in your field. Now you've inspired so many by achieving things that women haven't done before. What was the first record that you achieved?
On October 22nd, 1922, before I even had my license, I became the first woman to fly up to the elevation of 14,000 feet. I was so cheery after setting that record.
That's fantastic. I do remember reading about that in the papers. You were in the headlines everywhere across the nation. So that was your first record? Were there others?
Yes, ma'am. I've held 7 records since 1930 to now, 1935, both in speed and distance. Right now I'm preparing for a flight that I hope to achieve soon. I'm going to be traveling from Oakland, California to Honolulu, Hawaii. And that will make me the first person, not just the woman, to cross both the Atlantic and Pacific Ocean.
7. Holy cow. I hope that you continue to set new records and continue to be the first in many events in flying. Amelia, I bet you're looking forward to that flight. Do you think this flight will be as long or as difficult as your flight across the Atlantic?
Why, thank you. And no, I don't believe it will be. That's not only because I've now got more experience, but the planes have also advanced, which should hopefully help me out more, even though I prefer to use my own instinct.
So you fly based on instinct. You must have to be very skilled for that. Do you have a team that helps you fly on your journeys, or do you do it all on your own?
Well, since I started out on my first big adventure, I've had people help me. That's actually how I met my husband, George. He's over in the advance. Oh, look, there he is. Hi, honey.
Hi, George.
George has helped me so much, especially with my publicity. He helped me get endorsements with companies like Lucky Strike Matches and to help me publish my books.
I didn't know you wrote books. How many books have you written?
2 so far. I really enjoyed writing them and love that others can read them.
Now, I see that you came here today wearing your flight outfit. Is this what you typically wear?
I absolutely love to wear my flight suit. When I first got this jacket, I slept in it to break it in. I've always worn a scarf, and being a pilot, we always wear scarves, so it works. And my pants, these are Joshua pants, may I say, these are very comfortable. It's a rare occasion when I don't have this jacket on.
Well, you certainly make the outfit look classy, and you look very confident in it.
Thank you. Maybe one day you can have one, too. I'll even give you a lesson.
That'd be great. Well, I'm sorry to say, but we've ran out of time for you. Thank you so much for joining us. Tune in next week when we have Harry Houdini here on the show.